Be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. Right? Doers of the word, not hearers only. Right? Why are the laborers so few? Where is the fruit from the revival that's happening on the internet? Right? Well, there's a bunch of hearers only. They're right. Doers only. They're online here. They're online listeners. That's a hearer only. Right? Right? Like, I won't call him out, brother, in here. I said, yeah, I used to be that guy. I was chips on my chest and sitting at home watching, and I didn't get involved. But now it's in Orlando. Revival has come to Orlando. God has a church here. They're soul winning. I have no excuse.
Man.
Right? You want Orlando to just thrive for God? Then let's start waking some people up.
Man.
And it starts with yourself. You got to do the word. Look, we don't do the word to be saved. This is written to a saved person. You do the word now that you are saved, so you have the blessing of God on your life. Don't be a hearer only, deceiving your own selves, he says. Look at verse 23. For if any man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. Says the same thing here, word, right? Doer, natural face in a glass. What's this talking about? We have a natural face. Hey, I guess we have a spiritual face too. Right? You have a face in the body, and when you look in the mirror, you're going to see something. That's who other people see. That's you. Right? People have always told me I have a face for radio. I don't know what that means. I don't know if that's good or bad. You guys caught that. You're sharp. Sharp as a marble. All right. Let's move forward. Look at verse 24. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. Right? You look in the mirror, you forget. You look in the mirror, you forget what you look like. Can anybody imagine looking in a mirror and walking away and saying, did I have gray hair? Did I shave today? I forgot. I looked earlier, but I totally forgot. Did I have food all over my face? Right? Think what he's saying here. He said, "What somebody that listens to the word and doesn't do what it says is like somebody that looks in the mirror, they look at their natural face, and then they walk away. They don't do anything about it. Right? That's the online listeners. It's like they forget to change. I had another brother recently tell me, you know, we drive to church, we listen, you say, get rid of the TV. We say, yeah, he's right. We drive home, and by the time we get home, we say, well, you know, just a little bit of poison in my heart, just a little bit of that venom. Well, it's not like we pay for cable. I mean, we've got Amazon Prime, we've got Hulu, we've got Netflix, fill in the blank, it doesn't matter. I don't care if you're using YouTube for worldly stuff. You're letting the devil get in your heart. You're letting the devil get in your mind and spin this lie and entertain you and deceive you. And guess what you're not doing?
Right.
Reading your Bible. And that's exactly what he said. He said, it's funny because we made this decision on Sunday. And then on Wednesday, I was preaching about Jonah, and I mentioned about another family that I've known for several years that I didn't even realize they were listening to my preaching. And they texted my wife and they said, we finally decided we got rid of the TV. And I said this on Wednesday, and he said, we're watching you on the TV saying that after we made the decision, we were getting rid of this service, no more Hulu. And I'm like, well, that's cool. Praise the Lord, you know? So listen, they didn't forget what they look like, but for a while they did. What happened? They go to church, they hear the preaching, and then, well, you know, just a little bit of music. Just a little bit of movies, a little bit of the devil's leaven is okay in my life. I'm strong enough, I can handle it. But look, when you're confronted with it, when you're standing in front of the mirror, do something about it now. That's what it's saying. Look at the next verse, verse number 25. But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. The perfect law of liberty. I love that phrase. It's talking about the Bible. There's only one law that will set you free. That's have no other gods. That's believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. That's obey the gospel. That's the law that will set you at liberty, right? So he's talking about the Bible. That's your spiritual mirror. He's saying when you look at your spiritual face in the spiritual mirror and God through his Holy Spirit reveals something you need to change, don't be a coward. Decide right then and there, I will have revival. I will change this problem. I will ask God to help me to hate the whoredoms of Babylon. I want to love the Lord. I want to be effective for the Lord. And every day that you look in the mirror, that spiritual mirror, you read your Bible and you say, well, soul winnings, that's not for me. Reading more, that's not for me. Preaching, that's not for me. Listen, whenever you do that, you're looking in the mirror and you're saying, that's not for me. Why don't you just spit in God's face? If you're going to refuse what he's trying to show you, he says it's perfect. The perfect law of liberty is how you get revival in your life. It starts by you looking at your spiritual face in that spiritual mirror and doing something about it. What's wrong with their face? Hey, it's the spiritual face. That's the problem. It's not their real face. It's the spiritual face. That's where the problem's at. Obey when you see these things. Be a doer of the word, he says here. A doer of the work. What is a doer of the word? That's to do the work. Well, what work is he talking? Oh, I have to work to be saved? You guys know better than that. You're not like that fool, right? You're saved by faith alone, thank God. There's nothing you can do to go to hell. But guess what? Now that you're a child of God, he will correct you. Do you want God to correct you or do you want God to bless you? Answer that in your heart right now. If you want God to bless you, obey what he shows you out of his word. And guess what? Step one is to get in the word. If you say, yeah, well, I know he's going to tell me to quit that one thing, so I just won't read that. Wrong. That's a fail, right? Don't be a failure. Open your Bible. Find out what God says. Remind you of his principles. And he does. This is written to the saved that we need to obey. We need to keep his word. There's a commandment to preach the gospel. Are you keeping that one? There's a commandment to read the Bible. Are you keeping that one? There's a commandment to go to church. Are you keeping that? Are you just kind of, well, when I can, when I get around to it? Take it seriously. Right. You are the laborers in his harvest in Orlando. If you want a revival in Orlando, not just to say, we got a facility, we got a group, we got a billboard, we got a website. If you want a real revival in Orlando, it starts with you as an individual. Every one of you. You can't say, well, I go to revival. You say, I am the revival. I've decided I'll change. I've decided I'll read my Bible. I've decided I'll change my attitude. I'll fix my problems so I can be used of God. Revival starts in the individual. It starts in the heart. What are you planting? What kind of fruit are you guys going to plant here in Orlando? Some GMO oranges? Some old IFB church that won't preach the gospel right, that leaves out important facts? Or are you going to do something with some fruit that remains forever and ever and ever?